this Viking crap, didn't they? Look at all this stuff. They must have done okay for themselves, so how come I never heard of these guys before?
And this from the guy who learned about Ozzy Osbourne through reality TV?
Sleep. We all spend a third of our dreams
nice
in a soft
springs.
Embrace.
Man.
Somewhere between fantasy and oblivion.
Hey, remember when I got you that gig? Your first real writing job. What got you started? Was this one of your episodes?
In Night Springs. Tonight's episode. The Dream of Dreams.
Eh, that's by someone else.
We join Mr. Jones to see signs of this dreamscape.
Viking boat looked imposing, almost like a battering ram.
this stuff online, maybe get a reality show going, release a new single.
Open, okay?
As you regular listeners know, I tend to work through the night, but I'm not the only one. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton are taking a couple of moments off their busy schedule to join me here in the studio. Boys, how busy are you now? Deerfest is almost here, isn't it?
The elevator was dead. I'd have to get some power to it first.
Actually, Pat, we've been real busy with other stuff. Which concerns an ongoing investigation. We can't talk about that.
Saying we got, you know, the lions to the
I could see the building that had to be the Andersons' home on the other side of the field. It wasn't far now. I wasn't worried about trusting the ramblings of two burned-out geriatric wrecks. They had the goods.
Let's go, man.
You should feel right at home then.
Lights are out. I guess we better check the fuse box.
The power downstairs was out, but I was sure I could fix that at the fuse box. The power downstairs was out, but I was sure I could fix that at the fuse box.
You know, this place looks kind of lived in. I thought the Andersons were in the booby hatch. Come on, Al, let's get the lights on, huh?
Of course. We need to find where it's coming from. That's the message the Andersons talked about. That's the whole reason we're here.
Lady of the Light? Oh, that's gotta be, what's your face, the crazy lamp lady from the town.
Cynthia Weaver.
Right. Must be.
find Cynthia Weaver. We'll stay here for the night and head back to town as soon as it gets light.
Hey, Al. Lots of hours before dawn. Might as well get some rest. And by rest, I mean drunk.
Come on, Barry. This is... Yeah, what the hell?
Seriously, because I know we don't get along, but we're gonna find her, right? Even though you're a crazy bastard, I'm gonna stick by you, no matter what, ever, Al.
Sure, like a brother.
I'm a writer, goddammit.
Correct.
If I just wanted to, I could write 10 books a year. And they'd be the best books that year.
No, you couldn't.
That's right, I couldn't. But I could, because I'm a writer.
What? What do they put in this stuff? I feel like my brain is coming out of my nose. I'm gonna get the recipe off those coots and be a booze millionaire.
I just miss her, Barry. I just want her here with me.
I know, Al. I know. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna make it okay.
Crazy drunken dream, and yet it was more than that. It was the truth, a suppressed memory unearthed by the Andersons' moonshine. I was there, an out-of-body observer. This was the night Alice and I had arrived at Bright Falls, the night Alice had disappeared. I had a chance to find out what had happened. Whatever power had brought me back to this night at the lake was also stopping me from leaving. I had no choice but to see it through, to find out what had happened. I remembered being surprised to see the cabin dark. Alice would have never turned the lights off. This lost memory, there was nothing. I had to follow the footsteps of my past self to find out what had happened that night. I remembered thinking, I caught a glimpse of her form underwater, sinking into the darkness. Diving after her was the last vague memory I had of that night. After that, the next thing I could remember was waking up behind the wheel of the crash car and finding the first pages of the manuscript.
Oh,
couldn't find her in all that blackness. I must have thought she drowned.
Alice!
Jagger had Alice, and so she had me.
Alice!
I'd been easy prey.
Look at the cabin. Is there someone in the window?
Alice?
Maybe she didn't drown after all. Maybe she's inside.
Alice!
Yes.
Presence had touched me. She had dug her nails into my brain and used me, made me her puppet.
She must be here somewhere. Maybe upstairs in the study.
Alice!
Yes, that's where she is. You can apologize.
Alice!
You laugh at the whole thing together and put it behind you.
Alice!
She's not here. You were foolish to think so. No, she's dead. She drowned.
No, no, no!
It's your fault your wife is dead. You are guilty. All she wanted was to help you right. You killed her. Oh, hush. There's still hope. Cauldron Lake is a special place. Here, you have the power to change things. She wanted you to write. I will tell you what to do. You can write her back. The story will come true, and all will be well again.
She had Alice, and the manuscript was the ransom for her.
Yes. I'll write. I'll fix it. I'll bring her back. No. I wrote it.
I remembered it all now. In the dark, I'd written for days, a week, almost a complete manuscript of a novel entitled Departure. Jagger had been my editor, whispering in my ear, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. I thought I was saving Alice. Even with the cobweb she put in my head, some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story, to bring a light into the cabin to release me before I could finish, to interrupt the horror story before the ending, where darkness consumed everything and everyone. Zane was weak and far away, but I had written him into the story, and his light had been enough to set me free.
It isn't here now. I'm here because it was written. I brought the light to set you free. You must hurry. We'll know I'm here. It will be back soon. It stole the skin of my partner a long time ago. She looks so old.
I had woken up, confused and groggy, my mind consumed by darkness and fear. All I could do was to escape. The week spent in the cabin had taken its toll. I was barely conscious and fading fast. It had to have cost Zane terribly, thrown him even deeper into whatever dark place he now haunted. But he had managed to weaken the dark presence, kept me safe that night.
my fault.
That's right, James Joyce. It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
A horror story that is coming true. Jagger had been my editor, making sure that the unfolding story would make her more and more powerful. Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Together we can create something absolutely wonderful. The Lake,
it does something to the works of art created here. It makes them come true. My mom gave me this old light switch.
The clicker.
Alice is being kept in a dark prison. I need to find Cynthia Weaver to fix this.
It's your fault, and you're gonna pay for it.
Well, we're expecting a record crowd from the neighboring counties. Naturally, we hope to break the record set by last year's Moose Fest in our neighboring town, Watery. Ladies and gentlemen, some people have asked me, what's the big deal about Deer Fest? And I think that this sums it up. It's about friendship and community. We've got a great party coming up, but let's try to hold it in until tomorrow and get through the night in one piece, all right?
Someone will come for it when the time is right. Thomas said so. He wrote it. The key is insurance. It's my job to keep it safe. Safe in the light. What was in the light?
Hello.
All the manuscript pages were gone. The FBI agent had taken them.
I think my tongue just took a crap in my mouth. Ugh. Oh, wait, we're in jail now? Al, this is not good.
That about sums it up.
Oh, I am never drinking again.
I need to talk to Weaver. She's the one in the song, the Lady of the Light.
What, the crazy lady? Ugh, whatever you say, Al, but we're stuck here. They're not gonna...
We've interviewed Wake.
I had some reading to do first, Sheriff. And let me tell you,
it was an interesting read.
Well, I've got you now, Raymond Chandler. It's all here. All the evidence, including conspiracy to murder a federal agent. There's no way you're walking out of here.
You hear me in there, Brett Easton Ellis? Huh?
Agent Nightingale, I want to talk to your superior.
Well, we all want things, Sheriff. I wanted my...
Look, that's not possible right now.
Agent Nightingale, I insist. Wake, what's wrong?
Lady, are you stupid? It's a trick. It's an obvious trick.
Okay, I've had enough of this crap. Wake, I'm gonna trust you with this.
You're joking.
Agent Nightingale, your opinion would matter more if you were sober and if I actually believed you were here on official business.
Whoa! Get back in the cell, Stephen King. The only way you're leaving this place is over my dead...
Wait a minute. I know this...
Oh my God!
Light. We need light. It's the only way to fight this thing.
In my office. I've got your things there. Follow me.
Oh, man. We're sitting ducks with the lights out.
Stay cool. I can get the emergency power on. Things. Wake, what do I need to know? What do you need from me?
They can be hurt in the light, only in the light, and I need to find Cynthia Weaver. She can help me stop this.
Light. Check. Cynthia. She lives in the old decommissioned power plant. I can get you there pretty quickly in the rescue chopper. Come on, let's get back to your friend. Wheeler, I need you to stay here.
What? No!
We're going to fetch our ride, but I have friends who need to be warned about this, and I can't be in two places at once. I need your help.
Well, okay.
Here's a list of people and phone numbers. I need you to call them and tell them you have a message from me. Night Springs, okay? They'll know what to do.
Night Springs? Like the TV show? Gotcha. Oh, hey, that radio guy is on the list. Maine. Who's Frank Breaker? He related to you?
My dad.
Hey, is this like a secret society?
Can you do this? You'll be safe here. The backup power's on. These guys need to be alerted, just in case we don't come back.
You'll come back for me though, right?
As soon as we get the chopper ready. Thanks, Wheeler. I owe you one. Okay, let's go, Wake. Through the back.
My hangover wants a pizza. You think there's any way I could order one, Al?
Go. I'll open the gate for you once I'm across. You stay here in the light and cover me, Sheriff, okay?
Are you sure? Okay then, but hurry.
I needed to reach the rooftop to get to the other side of the broken gate. Hey, Sheriff! Your password, Night Springs? What's that all about?
It's a stupid joke we have. That Bright Falls is the original inspiration for the TV show. This town can get weird at times. Never this weird, though. We need to bypass the damaged control box.
What am I, an electrician? Hold on!
Thank you.
I'm gonna want explanations, you know. For example, what the hell happened to Rose? She's seriously messed up now.
The same thing I think happened to me after I arrived.
During this week, you can't remember?
Oh, I remember now.
You were helped!